What's up guys, CPModder here, back with another video. Today we're taking a quick little talk about having the correct mouse for your computing needs. Now yes, this is also to a talking head video, so I guess if you don't like talking head videos, alt tab and do something else while you have a listen to this. Anyway, having the right mouse for the job is actually really, really important when it comes to using your computers for a fairly long time. Now for a lot of people, having a standard little typical mouse that you might pick up from a bargain bin is totally going to be okay. However, if you plan to have long gaming sessions, long editing sessions, or just use your computer for long periods of time, you may want to listen up because having the right mouse can definitely save you a lot of pain and problems when it comes to using your hand. Now, when we think about buying a new computer, most of us are actually thinking about what CPU to get, what GPU to get, what case, how many RGB LEDs do we need, but very few of us are actually thinking about the peripherals and more specifically the mouse that we need that will actually suit what we want to be doing with our computer. But recently when I checked out the Rappu MT750, that really changed my idea on how I was thinking about picking up parts for a new computer, where the mouse actually became something that I would definitely consider. Up until recently, I've been using really whatever mouse I could get my hands on, from cheap little Microsoft wired mouses to wireless little things that are absolutely tiny in comparison to these guys. When it comes to mouses, I've never really been sort of caring about what I actually pick up. Thus, when I go ahead and use computers, I was finding I could really only use a mouse for no more than an hour and a half to 2 hours, mainly because my thumb and then all down my arm would absolutely be hurting so bad, and usually I'd stop, go do something else because I just kind of figured I couldn't exactly hold a mouse for that long. Turns out I was using the wrong mouse for my hand size and also too for the task that I was going to be doing. And this was because of these bargain basement mouses that really don't have too much ergonomics that actually go into the design of these things. I mean, let's face it, who puts their hand flat down on a desk whenever we go ahead and sit down? I mean, if you just have your arms out naturally and then rest them down, most of the time our hands will be on their sides, never really flat, which makes for an uncomfortable sitting position. So most of us want to have our hands on the side, and that is where more ergonomic mouses actually come in. Now, up until recently, I thought ergonomic type of mouses were kind of just like a marketing thing. I didn't really think that they could actually deliver anything better, and honestly, I thought they were just more expensive because people bought them for some reason. I really didn't give too many cares about it. But again, until one actually got sent to me for review, I was really, really surprised. So enter again the Logitech MX Master, or in my case, the Rappu MT750. In fact, a really decent mouse that offers some really good ergonomic features. Now just taking a look at this guy, just like my sort of thoughts, I always thought that ergonomic mouses were really not that great. They're obviously on a weird angle. If you look at them front on, they're kind of on a weird sort of angle and just something you don't really expect out of a mouse. When we think of a computer mouse, we think of this, which is totally not what this actually looks like. So having an ergonomic mouse really can be weird when it comes to looking at it. But I can definitely say, after using this guy for about 2 months now, damn, has my computer experience actually changed. From only being able to use a computer for about an hour and a half to 2 hours, to being able to sit there all day, no problems, using a mouse without any sort of injury to my wrist or arm, this thing has changed the way that I've actually been able to interact with my computer setup. And this is down to a few reasons. First off, the size. If we just take a look at some of the mouses that I was originally using, like this little guy, compared to this thing, the MX Master, or in my case, the Rappu mouse, is way bigger and better. Now, basically what this allows you to do is have much more of your hand taken up by the mouse, thus resting more hand on the mouse, being able to grip it in a much better situation. So the size of it definitely helps out there. On top of this, it also too helps to give a much more natural grip, and this is where the thumb resting platform thing comes in. I still don't exactly know what this little thumb rest is. I call it a wing, but I'm pretty sure it's not a wing. Either way, whatever it is, I found it to be so much better. Just like the whole idea of an ergonomic mouse, I thought they were kind of weird, why you would need like a resting pad for your thumb. I had no idea why, because let's face it, your thumb works okay on a regular mouse, but this thing is absolutely awesome. Being able to have your mouse actually move with your thumb and not having to hold your thumb up at all is another thing that also too helps down the rest of your arm when it comes to the muscles and stuff that's in your arm. Good thing I'm not a doctor, because I've no idea about that. Anyway, I was really surprised once again to find that the thumb resting pad thing actually was really awesome, and I guess that's why these companies put millions of dollars into these designs. So the thumb pad was another feature of just a more ergonomic mouse that really stands out over your kind of typical bargain basement little tiny mouses. And again, because of this thumb pad, it again forces you into a more natural kind of palm grip that is so much more comfortable to use than a more typical claw grip on a little tiny mouse. And finally, these types of mice also to put your hand in a more natural position. Earlier in the video, I did mention when you just put your arm down naturally on a table, it's usually on its side. It's very rarely that you're gonna naturally put your arm down flat unless you're like actively thinking about putting your arm down flat. Now, I'm sure some people do put their hands flat, but my point being, if you just have your arm out and then you rest it down, usually it's gonna come down on the side. And that's also to where these ergonomic guys come in, because they're angled ever so slightly more to be in a more natural angle of what your hand is doing. These type of deep wheel mouses that you do find in the bargain bin are straight down versus, again, these kind of 45 degree angles, which doesn't sound like a whole lot and doesn't look like a whole lot, but damn, when you put your hands on it and start using it, it is so much more comfortable than what you would find in a typical mouse type of setup. And all in all, having a mouse that is not only suited to you better, but also to is big enough and more ergonomic is actually more important than you may think. I definitely know now the benefits of having such a decent mouse is way better than your more bargain basement bin. And you do have to think about it. If you're gonna be spending, say, $10 or $15 on a mouse, it's better to double or even triple that, because there's a high chance you're gonna get that mouse and it's gonna outlast your computer that you're building 5 times over. I know for a fact the keyboard that I've been running up until recently was basically fine for the past 5 or 6 years now. I haven't swapped it out for a very long time. So when it comes to computer peripherals, it's usually worth actually spending a lot more on them than what you may think, because they're gonna be lasting way longer than your system in most cases, and having a nice mouse and nice keyboard even is gonna be delivering you a much better setup. Much like a better desk, chair, or even a better desk itself, having a better way to interact with your computer is so much, well, I guess, better for lack of, well, better words. So overall, having the right mouse that actually is ergonomic enough and suited to your hand is just so much better. Don't get me wrong, some gaming situations do call for more kind of typical flat style mouses, but if you're just doing Word document browsing, the internet, or doing video editing, having something that's gonna be suiting to your hand is so much important. But let me know what mouse you use down in that comment section. Personally, I'm absolutely loving this little bargain MT750 from Rappu. If you wanna find that video, it should have popped up here or linked down below. It is a really awesome mouse. I think they're only like 20 bucks on some places on the internet, so they're really, really cheap. Feel just the same as an MX Master, but damn, I really can't recommend these guys enough. Nevertheless, guys, thanks all for watching, and I'll catch you all in the next one.